Hey guys, welcome to my channel. I'm Rodal, author of Rival Rebels. These are some of the new logos for the Rival Rebels game. These are the skill badges. And over here are the unit logos. I made them all in one color or binary so that they are very light and can work with the SDF system, assigned distance field, to be able to be projected on 3D models and ships. In another video, I will go more into depth with the units and player skills. But right now, I want to show you an old experimental project that I made 2 years ago when I started learning Unity. Okay, so this one is the Voronoi cube type of thing, terrain generator. I've made a lot of terrain generators. It also has the sky system with the suns and stuff. It has these fake shadows. They're really cheap. They're just generated with the field itself. The idea was to take a normal voxel engine that uses cubes, make a generalization which extends to non-cubes, and then use Voronoi to detect those jitters and create shapes that would be cubes if you didn't jitter it, but add a random deviation to each cell, I guess, and create a varying shape so that no two voxels are equal. It's a kind of a technical mouthful, but it's a complicated idea that uses 3D Voronoi and jittering of the cell origins. It comes out with this very nice looking sort of, I'm not even sure what to call it, but it's like dynamic boxes, I guess. I'm not sure. It also uses color variations to sort of like mark off different areas. You can see here that the shadows aren't always correct. Right over here, see that there's an object over here and it's not exactly casting a shadow. And the shadows look kind of weird at nighttime. Oh yeah, and the stars are very blurry. I still didn't know how to code shaders when I did this. I mean, I sort of had a basic intuition, but I didn't actually write any noise yet for the shaders. I think this one was a very nice project. I really liked the outcomes, but it still generated too many triangles. I like the shapes that it made with the noise and the colors that it generates. Okay, let's see the wireframes. Wait. Oh, also, this terrain has infinite generation, so you can go in any direction as far as you want, and it dynamically creates more chunks as you go there. See, they're loading more chunks, and it's fully multi-threaded, so chunk generation does not slow down the main thread. I think this was pretty much the first time I used multi-threading for this type of thing, and it came out pretty nice. There's also a basic flamethrower here and some sort of thing launcher. It didn't really work very well. See that the stuff kind of sticks onto the camera. But yeah, if you stay still, it sort of looks good. It was a particle system I was trying out. Yeah. Pretty glitchy, but still functional. So let's look at the wireframes. So this is the part that is generated. There's a lot of flying stuff, and let's put wireframe. There we go. Okay, so this doesn't exactly have a uniform distribution of triangles, but that's because of the nature of the Voronoi cells. Some of them have to be... Well, what are all these colors? This is a weird shader. The idea was to just generate using a system that resembled boxes, but not actually have any true cubes, you know? So yeah, it makes these sort of hexagon-looking cool things. I found it interesting, yeah. It's a variation on, like, the Minecraft style of just using cubes everywhere. But see here, the shapes are very noticeable. It's very nice here. I wrote my own 3D mesh clipping algorithm to create these. There used to be a problem with this where random faces wouldn't generate. Like, they were the faces that were facing up. So there would just be holes in the mesh that you could fall through. But I fixed that. It was pretty much a problem with normal generation and division by zero. So yeah, that's this project. This is one of my favorites. Yeah, here again you can see the broken shadows. It also made these interesting caves down here, see? You can enter. Kind of laggy, but nice.
Thanks for watching. Rodal out.